extension, OpenStudio user script, alter or add model elements, and just click on this script again. Let's try this. I'm going to remove existing space shading groups. Hit OK. See, it totally do that. So it's the easiest way to do it. If you want to remove it, just select everything again, go to extension, same thing, go to add overhangs for projection factor. And let's say if I make it 0, will it delete it for me? Well, it did not. So you need to do it manually. So click on all these spaces, click on this shading device and hit delete. Come out of it, go to other space, the different space, double click on the space, click on this projection factor, shading device, click, hit delete, come out of space. All right, let me just do it one more time for you guys. I'm just going to keep one of the shading device. All right. So there are different ways to do it. The most preferred way to create shading devices is to use manual method. Like for example, I want to create a shading device, a funky shading device here for this window. Let's say I want to create a grid pattern, grill pattern kind of thing, grill pattern, something like what you see in most of office projects in bigger cities. So I'm just going to use the preferred way, the most convenient method here to create the shading devices. So I'm going to create a very complicated shading device here. Please follow up with me. If you have any questions, please rewind this video and look into it one more time. A lot of times people just try to create window device or shading devices on top of this window, which gives a lot of trouble. Like for example,